This lesson is on list comprehensions. This is something that wasn't covered in CS 101, but will be used in many future classes, including CS 212. List comprehensions are a powerful tool for quickly and concisely creating lists. For example, let's say you have a list of the Udacity TAs, like this. And maybe we want to write the TA names in uppercase, because lowercase is a little bit boring. One way we can do this is with a for loop, like this one. And let's see how it works. This for loop is really doing five different things. First, we create the empty list, bad uppercase TAs, and I've called it bad uppercase TAs to emphasize that this really isn't the way we're going to want to create such a list. Next, it generates the indices, and it does that here. These indices will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, because Udacity TAs is a list of length 6. Then we iterate over these indices. Next, we apply the upper function, and this is a function that just takes a string and converts all of the characters to uppercase. Finally, we append to the bad uppercase TAs list. And this code will be perfectly functional, but it is bad. It is ugly. And it is slow, which is why we have list comprehensions. And just to show that this code works, let's run it. And sure enough, we get a list of the TA names, and they are printed in uppercase. Using list comprehensions, we could solve this problem in one line of code. And here, Python recognizes that Udacity TAs is an iterable, and iterable just means any object that can be iterated over. So, for example, lists can be iterated over, strings can, and you'll see a lot of that in CS 212 in the first unit. Tuples, and if you don't know what those are yet, don't worry. These are all iterable objects. And this notation tells Python to iterate over all of the entries in Udacity TAs, call each entry name, and then apply this upper function to name. The brackets indicate that we want to put the results into a list. And that's the list that we see down here. Peter, Andy, Sarah, Gundega, Job, Sean. And actually, I'd rather print each name on its own line, so let's do that like this. That's better.